The following is the class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 9th chapter, text number 22 and 23, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in December of 1966 in New York.
Ananna Chintan Sangamam Jijana Pujupasate Tikham Nittan Jiptanam Jogat Chimam Bahamaham. Now, Lord Krishna is speaking about his own devotees. So far he has spoken about the elevationist, material elevationist. Even trai dhanma nuprapana gatagatam kama kama labhante. Repeating the same process, sometimes going up, sometimes coming down. This is the material process. Today I am the richest man, and tomorrow I may be a poverty-stricken man in the street. This is going on. As we find in this earth, so also by our pious activities we can be promoted in better planets. Then kine punne puno matkalubukam visanti. And when the result and action of past activities is finished, then again we are driven to the earth or down to then this earth. So this is going on. Lord Chaitanya says that eirupe brahmanda bhamite kono bhagavad ji. So this way, this cycle of different species of life, they are going on. So traveling in this way, somebody who is very fortunate by association of devotees, he gets the seed of devotional service. Eirupe brahmanda bhamite kono bhagavan. To achieve the seed of devotional service is a fortunate achievement. It is not very easy, because it ceases the cycle of different transmigration of the soul. By ignorance, we take the spot life as permanent settlement. And we think that we shall live here permanently and make arrangements to live here permanently and make assets for my children, for my nation. But we do not know that the cycle of transmigration is not fixed. I do not know in what next life is mine. I do not know when the who is coming as my son? Who is coming? Who is going out of the scene as my son? These laws we do not know. But we are chewing the chewed evam gatagatam kama kama anavanti. Under the spell of this illusory energy, you are captivated by this temporary sense gratification, and we have forgotten our real life. So those who are in the sense of his real constitution, of their real constitutional position, as Bhagavad Gita started from the very beginning, this very conception that I am this body is a beginning from the beginning of the Bhagavad Gita. This is this case that you are not this body. So you have to mold your life in your identification of spiritual existence. So far the materialist is concerned, they are chewing the chewed. Punapunacharvita charvanana. The example which I gave you the last day, that a sugar cane, one has extracted all the juice by chewing, and it is again thrown into the on the earth and somebody is king. So there is no Jews. So we are simply repeating the same thing. We do not question that whether this process of life can at all give us happiness. But we are trying and trying and trying the same thing. The ultimate purpose of sense gratification and the highest, topmost sense gratification is sex life. So we are trying, chewing, eschewing, which is extracting. But that is not the process of happiness. The happiness is different. Sukham aptam sikam jat tat atindriya grahyam. Real happiness is transcendent. And that transcendental means that I must understand what is my position and what is my process of life. In this way, this Krishna consciousness will teach me. So, those who are Krishna conscious, about them the Lord is saying, Ananna Sintayanta Ma. Ananna Sintayanta means always, 24 hours, without any deviation, always thinking of Krishna. Naturally, if you are engaged in the business of Krishna, then you will always think of Krishna. Anyone who is absorbed in certain particular business is always thinking of that thing. So, anyone who is engaged in Krishna consciousness, his business is to think of Krishna always. Just like you are reading, hearing of this Bhagavad Gita, it is spoken by Krishna. And if you think at home that this sort of speech was given by Lord Krishna, this is the essence. So that is Krishna Chinta. To think of Bhagavad Gita is also Krishna thinking. Because Bhagavad Gita is not different from Krishna, absolute. It is from the absolute world. There is no duality. In the absolute sense, there is no duality. If I speak something, because I am not speaking in the absolute, therefore my speaking and myself differ. But here I am speaking the words of Lord Krishna. Therefore, the words of Lord Krishna is not different from Krishna. So if we think of Bhagavad Gita, the instruction which we receive from Bhagavad Gita, that is also thinking of Krishna. Ananna Sintayantam Mam, always who are thinking about me, Jidana Pajjipasate, and why one should think of Krishna, unless he has fully surrendered to Krishna, unless one has taken the business of Krishna, he cannot think of Krishna. He cannot think of Krishna. Therefore, it is said, that ananna sintanta mana jidana pajupasate. Pajupasate means constantly worshipping in that way. Tesam nitya avijikta. Avijikta. He is always engaged in Krishna consciousness. Therefore, yoga chemang mahamaham. Not that only the materialistic people will remain happy. Krishna assures that one who is always engaged in Krishna consciousness, he happiness will not be given. He will be happy, also happy. Because I will make him, I will supply him whatever he requires. It is very easy to understand, just like somebody maintains his family, children. He all day works and he has the aim how his family member will be happy. Because he knows that those people, those children, they are fully dependent upon him. This is same consciousness. Because where from this consciousness comes, unless it is not in Krishna? Janmadasya jataha. In the Vedanta Sutra it is stated, whatever you think, whatever you see, it has its origin. And where is that origin? In Krishna. Unless in Krishna, this thinking is not there, that my devotees, Krishna, every one of us is son of Krishna, that's all right. But especially just like a very big businessman. All his employees, they are also taken attention by the person, by the boss. But special attention is taken for his own children. Similarly, Krishna, the Supreme Lord, he is answers for all living entities. But especially answers for his devotees. Samoham sarva-bhuteshu name vishasya-napriya is found in the Bhagavad Gita that the Lord says that I am equal to everyone. Nobody is my enemy and nobody is my friend. I don't show anyone any partiality because nobody is my enemy. How God can be anyone's enemy or friend? He is friend of everyone. But jetu bhajante maam sitya te suti mai. One who is devoted specially to the Lord, he takes a special attention. Then do you think that God is in that way partial? No. It is the, just like the sunshine. Sunshine is open for everyone. But one who does not take advantage of the sunshine, he keeps himself within the dark room. The sun, what can sun do? Similarly, this partiality of God, that he takes special interest of the devotees, because the devotees are able to take the supreme, the complete sunshine of Krishna. It is not the partiality of the sun or Krishna, but it is the capacity of the person who can take full advantage of the sunshine. One should come out of the darkness and take full advantage of the sunshine. The sun is open for everyone. Similarly, God is open for everyone. One who comes out of the darkness of ignorance, he takes more advantage of Krishna's favor. So therefore, it is his capacity. So he gives instruction to everyone. This Bhagavad Gita is meant for everyone. It is not only for Arjuna. Arjuna was his eternal devotee, and he had all knowledge. But Arjuna placed himself as one of us just to receive this instruction from the Supreme Lord. So this instruction is open to everyone. It is not Krishna's instruction, Bhagavad Gita, it's not limited within a circle, within a particular circle. No. It is for every living entity. Now, if anyone takes advantage of it, just like the sunshine is for everyone, the same sun in India and same sun in your America. You cannot say, this is American sun. Can you say? We cannot say, I see sometimes, because I am now foreigner, I see sometimes, the same moon is here, and same sun is here, the same cloud is here. Why I am foreigner? Nobody is foreigner. Everyone is under the sunshine. It is our misunderstanding. In God's kingdom, nobody is foreigner. Everyone is brother. The ultimate father is the Supreme Lord. That is Krishna consciousness. Even the animals. Why should we think animals are different from us and we shall kill them? No. They have no right. He is also your brother. So this is universal brotherhood. When you come to the open sunshine, we can see, everyone is eligible to take advantage of the sunshine. And so long we are in the darkness, we say, this is my room, this is your room. So for such persons who are completely in Krishna consciousness, for them there is no scarcity. This is very encouraging. No Krishna conscious person will think that I will be in scarcity, I will be in want. No. Be rest assured. You'll never be in want. He'll never be a monk. If you keep your full faith in Krishna, he'll always happily leave and he'll be given a chance of chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Here it is guaranteed. So if you take this advantage of Krishna Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, in whatever position you may be, you will never be unhappy. You will always be prosperous. So why don't you take this advantage? Be situated. You are a medical practitioner, that's all right. You are engineer, that's all right. You are a clerk, that's all right. You are a real estate man, that's all right. Never mind, whatever be. Everyone has to do something to keep his body and soul together. That is the law of nature. Niyata kuru karman tam karma jyaya uja karmana. Arjuna was Krishna's friend. But he never said that you stop your working. Rather he engaged him in his real work. He was a fighter, he was a soldier. He was declined to do the duty of a soldier. But Krishna induced him, no, you must become a soldier. So we may do whatever by God's grace or by nature's freaks we are situated, that doesn't matter. But if you take this formula, ananda chintayantam, always think of Krishna, then the result will be that you will never be unhappy. Just try, make an experiment. We don't say that you give up your engagement and become a mendicant or sannyasi like me and give up your wife and children. No. Krishna does not say that. He may ask them, why you have given your wife and children? I have given up my wife and children for this purpose. If I am engaged in family life, then I cannot do this missionary work. I have taken absolute center to this work without any disturbance. So, for a preacher, for a missionary, that is different. But for ordinary man, he does not require to give up his family, his home. You remain. You remain in your occupation, you remain at home. But chant this Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Is there any difficulty? Why don't you try? This is our mission. We don't say that you change your life. We simply say that in whatever position you are, you please chant. That's all. You please chant. You'll be happy. You'll be prosperous. Krishna will be pleased upon you. And he'll be never in scarcity. Is it not a very nice thing? He'll never be unhappy. He'll never be in scarcity. That it is guaranteed. Sisam Nityam Yuktana Yogachivam Mahama. Those who are thus engaged always in thinking of me. Well, you can do your business and think of Krishna. What is your heart? And that thinking may be, divert your attention. But if you chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, you will practice. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. But you will not be deviated what you are doing. But at the same time, you will be able to hear the sound, transcendental sound vibration. So, this is the formula given by the Lord Himself. Please try to follow it. Ananda Siddhartha. Always chant Hare Krishna. There is no rule, no regulation. Never mind what you are, what you are doing. Simply chant and hear. We are anxious that everyone may take up this simple thing. And Lord Chaitanya says from Padma Purana, Harinama, 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 Iva Kevana, Kalau Nasiva, 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 Dativan Natha. If you want to live just like animals, simply within the sphere of eating, sleeping, and mating, and defending, that will not solve your problem of life. Dharma hiti sam adhiko visesa you are elevated from animal life only for this reason, that you can take up this line of action, Hare Krishna. The animal cannot take up. So don't miss this chance. If I instruct a dog, my dear dog, please chant Hare Krishna, it is not possible. But for a human being, never mind in whichever country he is born and whatever religion he professes, that doesn't matter. This Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram is for everyone. It is not very difficult. So take up. Jitpanna devata bhakta jajanti sadhyani taha tipi mami bakanteya jajanti avidhipurvakam. Avidhipurvakam. Now, Krishna says, of course, in India, there are different types of worship that I have already explained. Mostly, they worship Lord Krishna. Mostly. At the 80% of the people, they are Vishnu worshippers. And 20% of the people, Hindus, they are worship of different gods and impersonalities like that. It's it. So, yes, Krishna says, but because that is recommended in the Vedic literature. Why? The Vedic literature that I explained the other day, that worship of different gods, that is also along with Vishnu worship. Aradhananam sarvesham Vishnu aradhanam param. Vishnu is the central point. Without Vishnu worship, with Krishna worship, no other worship is successful. So here, those who worship other gods, in this conception, that because God is everything, therefore, any demigod, because the demigod people, those who are less intelligent, they worship demigod to take immediate effect. Just like a man who is diseased, he is recommended to worship the sun. Now, that is effective. Either you worship, because when sun is worshipped, you have to go to the sun shrine and offer something of water and some pradeep. There are some paraphernalia. So, if a diseased man goes to the sun shrine, it actually is cured. Sun shrine has got scientifically also, it has got ultraviolet rays. So, one keeps, if he does not take any medicine, if he simply sits down and sun he will cure. Nature says. So either you take this way or that way. But one thing is that those who are worshipping sun for cure of disease, that for them, Bhagavad Gita says, Albavattu phalam pesan tad bhavati albamirusa. Antavattu phalam pesan. Now suppose you are diseased and you are cured by worshipping sun or becoming in the sun side. Do you think that is the solution of your life? You may be cured. So how long you remain cured? There you are, again disease. Again you are the sun sign. So this is called gata-agatam, chin vichi. The problem is why you shall be diseased at all? That should be the problem of intelligent person. Not that I become diseased and I worship sun or go to the doctor and be cured and again become diseased. No. Sukham Atman Sukham. You should cure from all sub diseases. So long you have this material body, you have got life, you have got birth, you have got death, you have got diseases and you have got old age. Besides other miseries. This is a permanent thing. Now, your human form of life is meant for curing for good all these inconveniences. You should not be satisfied by curing disease and again falling disease. No, that is not your reason. Therefore, Lord Krishna says, antaraptu phalam tisa. Those who are worshipping other demigods for some immediate result, their result is antaraptu. It is to be ended at a certain point. It has got end. So, such things are desired by alpamedhasam, those who have got less amount of brain substance. Why one should be satisfied by temporary cure? He must see that why I shall die? Why I shall be diseased? Why I shall go again into the womb of the mother? And why I shall become old? This is my problem. So if you want to solve all these problems, then you have to become the Krishna consciousness. Janma karma me divyam jujanati tasata tatta deham punajanma naiti ma naiti kaunsya. Anyone who becomes Krishna consciousness, even partially, simply to know Krishna, that he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, his activities are transcendental. Simply by knowing this, you will solve your all these problems. Simply by knowing this. Tatta deham punajanma, these things are stated in Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, in every way, if you make analytical study of Bhagavad Gita, then you have to become Krishna conscious. Bhagavad Gita is being preached all over the world in so many languages, but I'm sorry, they are not in the right way. Therefore, you are very serious to preach this mission of Bhagavad Gita all over the world, so that people may become happy and people may take advantage of it. That is our mission. And we invite everyone, every gentleman, every sandman to come and cooperate with us. This is a nice mission. We shall be glad to cooperate for the good of the all people of the world. Jagatyana nivartante tad dhama paramamma. The Lord says that if you transfer yourself in the kingdom of God, then you will have no more to come in this world of misery, full of misery. Thank you very much.